Hey guys, Sergeant First Class Bites here with the National Guard. Today I'm going to be talking to you about, can you choose your job in the National Guard? Now, the simple answer to that is yes, but there are some factors that you've got to look at before you actually get a job in the National Guard. One of the things that you have to do before enlisting into the National Guard and choosing a job is to take the ASVAB test. Now, your recruiter can schedule you for the ASVAB test, or you may have taken it in high school. Now, the ASVAB is what determines what jobs you qualify for. So on the ASVAB test, you will get an overall score, which is called the AFQT, and then you will get line scores within that overall score. Once you have completed the ASVAB, your recruiter will be able to take those scores and determine what jobs you are eligible for. How I do it personally is I generate a list of all the jobs that the person that I'm working with qualifies for, and then beside those jobs, I also let the applicant know if those jobs come with extra incentives, such as a sign-on bonus and the Montgomery GI Bill kicker. Once you have taken the ASVAB test and your recruiter has given you a list of all the jobs you qualify for, there's some things that you're going to need to take in consideration. When you link up with your recruiter, you may have already determined what position you want to do in the National Guard. And if your ASVAB score meets the line score requirement for the position you're interested in, then you can just simply do that job. But that job may not be right in your hometown. See, how the National Guard works is we've got armories stationed all over your state, but every armory doesn't have every position we have available. In the National Guard, we have roughly 200 different MOSs available. But again, not every armory has all 200 positions. Now let's say that you're interested in being a military police officer and you live in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Well, the local armory in Chattanooga may not have 31 Bravo military police positions available. However, 30 miles up the road in Cleveland, Tennessee, there are military police officer positions available. But in Chattanooga, there may be numerous other positions available that you qualify for. It's going to come down to you and your recruiter on what position to take. It'll ultimately be your choice. I highly recommend you speaking to your recruiter and asking for his or her opinion. Because as a recruiter, we don't get paid for what job you sign up to do. We don't get paid more or less if you get a sign-on bonus. We don't get paid any extra money for being recruiters for you enlisting. So we're going to give you an honest answer. There's no reason for us not to. So, there's a 31 Bravo military police position in Cleveland. It's 30 miles from your house. And then there's a 25 uniform position, which is communications position, that's available in Chattanooga. It's up to you if you choose the position in Chattanooga, which say is 5 miles from your home, or if you want to drive to Cleveland, which is 30 miles from your home. That's completely up to what you want to do. But let's throw a little monkey in the wrench. What if that 25 Bravo or 25 uniform position in Chattanooga, where you live, has a $15,000 sign-on bonus? Again, it's up to you what you want to do. Well, you're very interested in the military police position. However, 25 uniform or 25 Bravo sounds pretty exciting. It's close to home and it comes with a $15,000 sign-on bonus plus the Montgomery GI Bill kicker. The military police position does not have any extra incentives, so it does not come with a bonus and it does not come with the GI Bill kicker. What are you going to do? It's up to you. But again, talk to your recruiter about it and ask for his or her suggestions. We spend every day doing this job so we can guide you in the right direction, and we do this job to help you. So let's do a quick recap. Can you do whatever job you want to in the National Guard? You can, as long as your ASVAB score meets the line score requirement for that position. Regardless, all of the jobs you qualify for, your recruiter can lay those positions out for you, and then you make the decision on what job you want to do. So in the National Guard, you are able to choose the job that you want to do. The higher you score on the ASVAB, the more jobs you're going to have available to you. You need at least a 31 to get into the National Guard on the ASVAB test. If you score a 50 or higher on the ASVAB test, you may qualify for extra incentives. This is Sergeant First Class Bites with the National Guard. Thank you for watching.